Happy morning, children. Welcome to 7th Standard English class. Children, I am very happy to meet you through this video. Last class, we have seen how to write a letter writing. Today, we are going to learn Unit 2 Prose. Take your e-book, turn to page number 25. The title of the lesson is The Wind on Haunted Hill, written by Ruskin Bond. Now we will see about the author. Ruskin Bond is a story writer, novelist and poet. He is a favorite writer of Indian children and born on 19th May 1934. Simplicity and fluency of language and an insight into human nature are the hallmarks of this child. His major writings are The Room on the Roof, An Island of Trees, A Bond with the Mountain, The India I Love. So, there are three sections in this lesson. Before we move on to section 1, we will see the characters of this lesson. Usha is the main character in this lesson. She has dark hair and rose cheeks and 11 or 12 years old. Next comes Suresh, Usha's younger brother, 8-year-old boy, chubby and almond eye. Then, at last, Binya, Usha's friend and neighbor. She lived with her grandfather and her father was in army. Children, now we will see section 1. Usha goes for shopping. The lesson starts with describing the nature. The oving wind blew from the Himalayas over the hills and trees. It passed the haunted hill and reached the village on the slope of the next hill. So what is the meaning for haunted? It means a place frequented by ghosts. I repeat, haunted means a place frequented by a ghost. Usha, her brother Suresh and her friend Binya spread their clothes out to dry, firmly holding them by rocks. Here the word firmly means forcefully. They rested a while there. Usha planned to go for weekly shopping. Binya could not go with her. Suresh was willing, but he had to help Grandpa to chop wood. Here the word chop means to cut. And Suresh was worried about how Usha would return alone in the dark passing the haunted hill. Grandfather told a story about an English family which lived on the haunted hill 100 years ago, and the family members were killed by lightning. Grandfather had seen the two children of the family often playing in the moonlight near the ruins even now. So what is the meaning for ruins? It means building that has been destroyed. This frightened them. Usha went for weekly shopping, passing the fields, hills, ruins and valley. The ruined house had crumbling walls with wildflowers. Here the word crumbling means breaking. A wild plum tree in the floor of the large hall, lizard on the stones and singing bird on the empty window. And then Usha bought soap, matches, spices, sugar, pipe stem, exercise book, marbles, and necklace at the bazaar. She went to Aunt Lakshmi's house for tea, and when the clouds gathered for rain, she hurried home after collecting her mother's slippers from the cobbler. Children, now we will move on to section 2. Storm on the Haunted Hill. The clouds and thunder were threatening to rain, so Usha hurried to reach home before dark. She did not have an umbrella, but only a shawl and a scarf. Now the raindrops came faster. It was dark and lightning. Usha ran to the ruins to take shelter from the heavy winds and rain. She moved sideways to reach the corner of the old roof for shelter, but touched a wild cat and was frightened. It was dry and more sheltered at the old fireplace opposite, but she did not know the way in the darkness. Her clothes and long black hair was soaked. Here the meaning for soaked is extremely wet. The sound of the tin sheets and the storm blotted out all other sound. Here the word blotted means marked. The lightning and thunder were often. Usha remembered grandpa's story about lightning killing the English family and prayed it would not strike her. Suddenly, when the lightning flashed again, Usha saw two small figures at the opposite wall near the disused fireplace. They could have been the children. Now we will see section 3. A Night at the Haunted Hill. Usha wanted to leave the ruined building after seeing the two ghostly creatures. As she rushed out, she bumped on something and screamed. Here the word bump means to knock with force, and the word scream means to cry loudly. There were reply screams, and it was of Suresh and Binya. They had come looking for Usha in the stormy night. They were surprised, relieved and happy. They decided not to go home in the dark, thunder, lightning and rainy night when the paths also had fallen. Together, they had warmth and confidence and stayed in the ruins all night till the morning. They left the ruins on the top of the hill as the rain had stopped. Birds began to sing. The sky was pink and bright, and Suresh was hungry. As they were climbing down home, Usha saw a hand waving at them from the broom. Binya said it was the sway of the plum tree. Here the word sway means slow movement from side to side. But Usha also heard voices on the wind saying goodbye. Usha wondered if it was just the wind or ghost. Children, here the story ends. So, the moral of the story is, there is no illusion greater than fear. I repeat, there is no illusion greater than fear. Here the word illusion means a false idea. Okay children, now we will see the glossary of the lesson. Turn to page number 29, section 1. Maunder, make a long or a low sound. Haunted, possessed. Ruins, decayed, collapsed building or place. Terrible, fearful. Saddle, low point on a ridge between two summits. Crumbling, breaking apart into small pieces. Scuttled, ran with short, quick steps. Whistling thrush, a small singing bird. Straggling, spreading out in different directions. Moving on to section 2, this is page number 32. Forbidding, unfriendly or frightening. Foliage thrashing, hitting leaves and branches. Flicker, shine. Startle, frighten. Remnant, who, what was left. Crouching, bending down. Groaned and clattered, banged together and made a loud noise. Puddle, pool of water. Blotted out, hid. Streak, line. Sizzle, hissed like something hot on a frying pan. At last, section 3, page number 35. Stumbled, lost one's balance. Giggle, laugh lightly. Huddled, crowded together. Exactly, feeling great eagerness. Children, hope you all understood the lesson. For today's assignment, you are going to write the short answers and paragraph answers in your classwork note. So children, complete the given assignment and report as task completed between 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. without fail. Thank you, children.